If you want to monitor live off the floor your input, I suggest you to use BusSend to send out your signal from the input of the console, from the channel strip. You want to send them out to floor monitor if you are doing live sound. If you have headphone amplifier, set up your headphone amplifier using BusSend and use that to monitor your input, live input out of the back of the console. That way you won't have any kind of latency. For those of you who don't know, latency is happening when you send out signal into the computer and it takes some time for the computer to process it, to apply some EQ, to add stuff to it and send it back out. The console itself has around 3 milliseconds of latency. Anything under 5 is almost not noticeable, because some people do, but for the few rare who does, I'm sorry, we're not gonna take that into consideration right now. When it's time to set up BusSend, there's a couple things you need to know. I'm gonna guess here that you never did a BusSend before. The first thing that you need to check is that your BusSends are up. Right now, I just defaulted the console, and by default, like the physical BusSend, like a master out, is not up. So we're gonna raise them. Most of you probably won't use more than 8 bus, so those 8, put them at 0 dB, like I'm running my master at 0 dB. And to build a monitor mix, we're gonna select bus 1, and we're gonna select send on fader, the knob right next to it. All the channels are currently mute in that BusSend. We're gonna unmute them, or the one that we wanna use. Let's say we're gonna keep going with the example of having drum microphones. So we're gonna have a drum microphone and we're gonna send them in the mix. You can also do it from the screen if you don't wanna use the send on fader function. In every single input you have here in the bottom, a bus send for each bus. Here you have the tap option for bus send. I suggest you to use any of the first 6 tap point, because whatever you will do with the fader, the physical fader that goes out to the main, won't affect the send into that bus. You will create some pre-fader bus send for musician to monitor themselves. Whatever you do in the mixing booth won't affect what you send to them. It will be independent one from another. We're just gonna leave it at 4, because at 4 will be between the EQ and the compressor in our chain, because this is our signal chain on the console itself. So if we apply filter, it will affect what goes out in the monitor. If we apply gate and EQ, compression will not be a part of that signal. Everything will be taken before compression. And this is something that I suggest you to do. Compression can make them feel like they are limited in volume. So to avoid that, don't send compression, don't send a compressed signal in their headphone monitor. It will also give you, when you record, a more even performance, because they will try to level themselves with the band or with the other musician. This is what great musicians do. They don't just play, they mix themselves or try to blend themselves with the rest of the band. So once you do that for every channel, right now channel 1, channel 2, let's say channel 2 a little lower, 3 a little lower. Once you've set a mix for the musician to listen to himself, maybe you want to send him a click track, or when you are done recording, you want him to hear the performance he just did. We're gonna go to our channel 41, we're gonna send it into bus 1. That is the mix that we send to our musician. So that way, if we play a click track and send it into bus 1, the musician will hear it in his headphone. Try not to use a click track if you are using floor monitor. You will definitely hear it in all the microphone that you have around. That's not a good idea. So if you want to use click track, headphone is a must here. We're just gonna take a quick look at what's going on in the routing also. In the routing section here, output, when you select output, local out, the basic state of the console when we initialize it. Give us 6 mono bus send out of the XLR in the back, 1 through 6. The wing has 16 output plus the digital one, but I'm not gonna count them. We have 16 output. We're gonna use 2 of them for our headphone or our studio monitor. So that leaves us 14 output. 14 output can be 14 mono output or 7 stereo output, because you need 2 physical connection to create a stereo bus. What we just did was a mono bus end for headphone, but if you want it to be stereo, I'm gonna come here, I'm gonna unlock our patch, and in physical XLR2 instead of bus 2, we're gonna send out bus 1 right. Let's go take a look back at our input A1 aux in 1 USB return from the computer 1 and 2. Here we have a pan knob, so you can adjust the pan. You probably want to leave that in the middle because that's a stereo input. It's 1 and 2 stereo input on a stereo track. But let's say if we were to have a drum, and 7 and 8 would be our overhead, I would try to pan the overhead on the left and the left. And if you're gonna use a stereo track, this rule doesn't apply. Let's say that your overhead are stereo, the left channel will go in the left channel of the bus, the right channel of the input will go in the right output of the bus. This example applies to any mono source. If you want to create a stereo image in a mix, like if you were watching a band or a drummer having his different microphone physically placed, like if he was looking at his drum kit. Right, that way when the drummer is gonna play or any kind of musician is gonna play, he's gonna hear the drum in stereo. It will give him a more open mix because he will have, you know, our ear are stereo. We're just mimicking that now with 2 speakers next to her and panning those mic left and right. One last thing with monitoring. Let's say that we want to use the headphone out and give those headphone to a singer so he can record his performance. He probably wants to hear something different than you. So you want to build him a bus send with the right amount of everything. You can just press solo on that bus send and he will hear that into the headphone, and you, if you are plugged somewhere else, not in aux out 7 and 8, if you are in the XLR in the back, you will hear the main out, so you will have 2 separate mixes. If you have a headphone amplifier like the one from Behringer, they are great, affordable, 8 microphone preamp and a rack space. You can send out a bus feed from the XLR in the back and put them into headphones, so everybody in your studio can have a different headphone mix. This is usually the way to go. And when you engineer a session, you want to make sure that everybody hears what he needs to hear in his headphone at different level so he can perform really well for that session, because performance is the key. Doesn't matter what microphone you have, what console, what mic preamp that you have, if you have a good performance, it will sound great. If you liked that video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more video about the Wing, both live and in the studio, subscribe to the channel. Until the next one, please take care of yourself, and I see you guys later.